young lad, you know, he was having a little problem growing up, I guess. Well, anyway, he had a couple sisters. And of course, he had his mother, too. You know, they all lived together in their little house down by the railroad tracks. Well, anyway, for breakfast in the morning, old mama would be sitting there, and she'd ask the little children sitting around the table what they'd like for breakfast. You know, she'd come up to the one little child and say, "What would you like this morning?" And she'd say, that little child would come back and say, "Oh, butter and toast, mama." She'd go up to her second child and ask them, "What would you like for breakfast this morning?" And she says, "Oh, you know, mama, just butter and toast would be fine with me." And she'd go up to her third child there and ask him, "Son, what would you like for breakfast this morning?" And, you know, as hard as he tried, he just couldn't quite get it out. He goes, and he just couldn't quite say it. So mama just said, "Well, hush your mouth, brother. You're going to get what the rest of the kids get." And, you know, this is going on. Sure enough, next morning, old mama's asking again, "Oh, what you want for breakfast, children?" And one little girl, she comes out there and says, "Oh, I want the toast and butter." And she goes to the next little child and asks him. He goes, "I want the jam and jelly and toast today." And she says, "Oh, yeah, that's okay with me." You know how it was back then. They didn't have a lot, you know. Toast and jelly was quite a bit. And she went up to her little boy and asked him, "What would you like for breakfast this morning, son?" And he tried, you know, he went, and she just said, "Hush your mouth, child." And as she was walking back in the kitchen, she says, "Lord have mercy, I don't know what's wrong with my boy." You know, the little boy, he heard it, you know, he's upset now, he didn't know what to do. So he grabbed his little flour sack, you know, packed it up, because he put some toast in there, some butter maybe. And he had moved on down the road. You know. But anyway, as he's walking up this road, he came across Mr. Charlie. He was sitting out in front of his rolling mill. You know, everybody knows what a rolling mill is, right? And there used to be a lot of them around here, I understand. They probably all burnt down. I think there were a lot here. Anyway, he walked up to him and he grabbed him on the old shirt sleeve there. He goes, Mr. Charlie goes, "Hush your mouth, boy, I ain't got time for you." And he finally got it. He wanted a job. Old Charles, he goes, "Well, son, I don't know, I got this rolling mill here. I got an old bunkhouse out back. And if you want to, you can stay there. And if the mill ever catches on fire, just come on down to my house and let me know. You'll have a home with me for as long as you're alive." And the little boy was so happy that he went running back to the old bunkhouse, made his bed, you know, put his little flour sack away. Well, sure enough, that rolling mill catches on fire one morning. And the old boy's running around, he's excited as can be. He can't even say a word yet. But he's trying, that old mill's burning away. He's running down the street, and he's trying to call Mr. Charles. And he's running up, and he's yelling and screaming. Old Charles is looking at him. Now, he just forgot what he told the boy, that he could stay there. And he comes running up to him, and he's grabbing him and grabbing him. And he goes, you know, and old Charles going, "Come on, boy, you can say it." He's trying, you know, he's really trying. As soon as this comes around, we're going to see what he does. But anyway, old Big Charles told him, "Son, you can't say what you want to tell me. Why don't you sing it?" And he goes, he said, "Oh, Mr. Charlie, yeah, you're rolling mill.